Hi everyone, welcome back. My name is Tessa with BitTitan, and if you didn't join us last time, I am joined today again by our Director of Business Development in our APAC region, Brad Rosero. Brad, do you want to hop in and say hi again to those who didn't join us last time?
Hi everyone, thanks Tessa. Yeah, hi guys, I'm Brad, of course, from Australia, based out of Melbourne. So yeah, good to see you again, and hopefully I get to see you in person sometime very, very soon. So
yeah, wouldn't that be nice?
Yeah.
Well, speaking of, you are based in Australia, and obviously COVID-19 changed the world. So in your region specifically, can you tell us a little bit about the cloud migration activity that's been kind of what's been going on?
Yeah, really good sort of question, Tess. And there's been, as everyone knows, so much has happened since, COVID, and it's still continuing to, things sort of sort itself out after, the post sort of COVID situation here in Australia. I mean, I can say there was a lot of activity and people just sort of scrambling, businesses scrambling to have that sort of business continuity, sort of in their business, especially if people working at home, including myself. I'm sitting here in my home office, right? So if you weren't in the cloud, it was very, very difficult for you to actually have that business continuity happening. So we saw a lot of businesses, contact our partners, of course, us directly to help them, migrate and move into the cloud so they could use, solutions and services like the Microsoft ecosystem, like Teams and all the products that they have available. So it's been a big scramble. I'm not going to say it's finished yet. There's still so much more to do. But we are definitely helping a lot of our customers as much as possible, make them transition into the cloud environment.
Right. Did you see more activity coming from certain industries than others?
Yeah, we noticed a few actually. The tourism industry had a bit of a downturn in what was happening, but we saw that a lot of the major travel flight sort of agencies look at doing some migrations at that downtime because it wasn't going to affect their business. So we saw a lot of activity there. Of course, in the higher education space, like the universities, there was a lot of movement there with tenant to tenants within their own environment, but also just moving from one ecosystem into a newer ecosystem. So there was those huge opportunities there for those industries, and they're big industries here, definitely here in Australia. So.
Right.
And one of the other things that, people were sort of doing, as I mentioned earlier, was working from home. I think that's here to stay. I think the whole office going in 9 to 5, Monday to Friday, is probably going to change forever. You can probably see a lot of businesses now giving their employees maybe the Friday and the Monday at home.
Right.
And then they've got this long weekend. They're still working, but then Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, they're in the office just to sort of break it up a bit. And there's just so much more productivity, happening within the industry itself. Because I've just personally noticed I went from 1 hour chunks in my diary to half an hour chunks because we could get a lot more done in half an hour. And we had a lot more calls happening within the day. So, and I think that's probably here to stay as well. So there's been some change, of course, just in the way we operate as a business.
Yeah.
And then, of course, there's been a huge change just with a lot of organisations that want to move over to the cloud, and we're there to assist them in every way. And more importantly, just try and do that in a more cost-efficient sort of service as well. It's what we can do.
Right. I mean, as far as working from home, I went from at the beginning of all of this to having to acclimate to working from home all the time. And now I can't see myself going back into the office.
It's so hard, isn't it? Yeah. It's really hard. And that's the thing. Like just, commuting, normally I would commute from, from home to the office for an hour.
Yeah.
Now I just commute for a couple of steps and it takes only 3 minutes,
I come downstairs in my living room and I have a desk and everything, which is nice. Yeah. It eliminates, like 30, 40 minutes when I'd have to sit in traffic in Seattle. So.
Yeah, it's a better use of time. So rather than spend 2 hours or an hour in traffic, you can be having some calls, like I said, having half an hour chunks of calls.
Exactly.
And you've already done 3 or 4 calls before getting to the office. So, there's been some real positive that's come out of the whole pandemic. So, crazy.
Well, I'm hoping one day I'll get to see you again on the other side of the world.
Yeah, one day soon.
One day.
Catch up. Yeah.
Well, thanks again for joining me. It was great to talk to you again. And to our viewers, stay tuned. We'll be back for more soon.
Thanks, Tessa. Likewise. Thanks, guys. Bye. Bye-bye.